Hi everyone, very welcome to my channel. I hope you all are doing really great and I hope that you and your all family members are well. I have recently crossed 100 subscribers. Thank you so much and I really appreciate whoever has subscribed to my channel. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, then please subscribe it because it is free and I keep posting videos related to PhD or MS in US or Canada, and most importantly how you can come here with full funding. In full funding, basically I mean like you will be basically in US full funding. The universities generally provide full tuition fees waiver and either teaching assistantship or research assistantship. So full funding in the sense like you don't have to pay anything, everything gonna be paid by the university, but on behalf of that you have to work for 20 hours or like lesser than 20 hours per week depending on your university, depending on your department. Received so many comments and so many emails regarding how I have approached professors when I was applying, and also you people wanted to know that what are the procedures or what are the steps you can follow while approaching professors or approaching your supervisors. So in this video basically I'll be making 10 points, 10 important points that you can follow before approaching professors or while approaching professors. Those 10 points if you will keep in your mind, then probably they're gonna help you. So without further ado, let's get started. The first step before approaching any professor is to read about the professor. Here in United States or in Canada, you will be getting about each professor in their particular department's faculty list. Go to their website, research them properly. On their website, you will be finding their resume, their area of interest, their current projects, as well as their projects maybe they have done 10 years back. So make sure that you are going over this properly and you are applying or approaching only to those professors whose recent research interest is aligning with your area of research interest. Maybe like just I'm doing in economics, so just think about I'm doing something related to gender economics. I'm trying to approach a professor and the professor maybe has done this particular work 10 years back, but right now maybe the professor has completely different interest, maybe in international trade the professor is working in. Then there is no point if I'll be applying to that particular professor because the professor is not working. So make sure that you are applying or you are approaching to those professors whose recent area of interest is aligning with your area of interest. And how you will get to know that? Obviously, go over their profile properly. Everything is written on their profile, so just go it properly. Just read it properly. Second most important thing, or the mistake generally students do, even like I did also 2-3 times, like sending generic emails. Like we feel like is it possible to send separate emails so to maybe 500 or 600 professors? So what we do, we just write us 5-6 templates of generic emails and we start sending. Don't do that. Go over their profile properly and write them why you are interested into that particular professor. So for that you need to write them what are their research area they're doing and how their research work is aligning with your research work and why you are exactly interested in working with that particular professor. So for that you need you cannot send generic email to each professor. Unfortunately, you need to spend time and you need to send different emails to different professors. Third point or third mistake generally people do is sending or writing too many paragraphs. Don't do that because it's not that only you or I have sent them the emails. They are getting almost 10 to 20 emails, even more if they are really renowned in their area. So they are getting so many emails, so they don't have that much time to read each and every email. So you need to make sure that you are making your email you can highlight those areas you want to focus on, and don't write more than 3 paragraphs. In the first paragraph you can write about yourself, as well as in the second paragraph you can write why you are interested, and in the third paragraph kind of conclusion or something like that. And if possible then you can bold some areas, or in italic also you can use. Don't write more than 250 to 300 words. I can't give this is the most important part. I cannot give much more emphasis on any other point than this one, that even if your area of interest is exactly aligning with that particular professor, still don't write more than 250 to 300 words. If you want to let them know more about you, then obviously You can attach your resume, as that also you write on the email that you are attaching your resume in case they want to look, or in case by going over your email they feel like okay, they are also interested, then they'll look after your email and according to that they'll take the decision. But don't write more than 250 to 300 words. Fourth important point is that write them exactly what you want. It's not like you are just writing your interest and they can't understand that why you are writing to them. Don't do that. Just write them exactly why you are writing to them. Do you want to do any research assistantship with them? Do you want to take admission for MS program in the department? Do you want to take admission for PhD program in the department? So what is your exactly thing you are looking for? So make sure that you are writing to them. And also write them for which year or for which session you want to apply to, because here in US or Canada there are two sessions, fall session and spring session. So if you are planning to apply for spring 2022, then write them that I'm writing you for admission for MS or PhD for spring 2022 or for fall 2022, whatever you want to do. Or also if you are already in US or Canada, or if you want to just work with them as a research assistant, that also write them that I'm open for doing some research assistantship with you. Whatever your situation is, just explain them and be sure or be specific what you want. Now, the fifth point is grammar and spelling mistakes. Don't do that. Write an email before sending to any professor. Make sure that you are going over it properly. Here, in most of the time, thankfully, when you are writing anything in Words, then definitely Word document gonna show you if you have done any, any kind of spelling mistakes or any kind of grammatical mistakes. But go through properly. If possible, then ask your friends or any of your, anyone you know to go over properly, so that you won't, there is no chance that you are overlooking any mistakes. And also another point, here in US and in India, the kind of spellings we write little bit different. Just an example of labor. In India, we write L-A-B-O-U-R, but in US it is L-A-B-O-R. So make sure that you are not writing the spelling as per your country, you're writing the spelling which is acceptable in US. Sixth point, as I already said, that attach your resume. Doesn't matter whether the professor gonna read it or not, but make sure that you are doing everything from your end. So you are attaching your resume, and in your resume, make sure that every point is very clear, what you have done, what currently you are doing, what are the achievements you have already, what are the things you have already achieved, if any particular project you want to focus on. So everything you will explain. And also don't make your resume more than 2 pages. If possible, then finish it in 1 page. In case it is not possible, finish it in 2 pages. Don't linger it. Don't make it till 3 pages, because again they don't have that much time to go over 3 pages. They won't do it. Now, when you can start your, emailing professors. So try to email them as early as possible. Try to email them prior to 3 to 4 months of the deadline, because they take too much time to reply. If you were planning that maybe December, 15 December is your deadline, and if you are planning to emailing them from 1st of December, then there is high probability that before the deadline you won't get to know anything from them. So make sure that 3 to 4 months prior you have started to approaching professors. And also don't get disheartened if they are not replying you back. Most of the time, if you are applying or approaching to 600 to 700 professors, hardly 30 to 40 professors gonna give you any kind of reply back. Don't disheartened. Being an Indian, the major drawbacks we are having is that generally we don't get any email address from our universities. Most of our Gmail addresses are Gmail or Yahoo. So most of the time, those any kind of email from Gmail or Yahoo, they generally go into their spam box. They don't see it, even those particular spam box or junk boxes. So because of to reduce all these kind of problems, it is better to keep emailing as many professors as you can, as many times as you can, and also as early as possible. And don't email them within 1 week. If they are not replying to you within 1 week, let them time, or even 2 weeks also, give them time. Probably they'll reply you back. Other than that, they may feel like you are so much impatient, you are not respecting them. So better send them email, wait for 1 to 2 weeks. If you are not getting anything back from them, then again you can send them back another email, any follow-up email. And while you are writing email, it is also important that you write them that if they want to conduct any interview or if they want to have any Zoom call or anything, then you are available for it. And if you are already in United States or in Canada, and if you feel like you can directly go and in person you can meet them, that also make sure that you will be writing them so that they will get to know your exact situation. And the last important point, if you are changing subjects, then also try to, you know, convince them that why you are changing your subject, why you are changing your majors, and why you are thinking that in that particular major you want to apply to will be helpful to you, and how you will be, you know, beneficial for that professor in that particular area. I hope that this point gonna help you while you will be approaching professors, and you will end up getting positive reply from many of the professors. And best wishes for your application. Stay happy and stay healthy in this situation, and try to, you know, help as much as possible you can to your family members or to your neighbors or whoever you can. Bye bye. Thank you.